Hello world and welcome to a brand new Azure vlog. We just hit over 1,000 subscribers on this YouTube channel. I think this is amazing. When I started this YouTube channel, I wanted to combine two hobbies of mine. Videography, but also my love for Azure. And as I see the increasing numbers of members on this YouTube channel and also viewers on my video, I can conclude that you also like it. So thank you so much for that. This really motivates me to create more and even better content. In this Azure vlog, I will talk about analytics rules in Azure Sentinel. And this will be one of the longer vlogs. I will do a total story of creating an analytics rule, defining the KQL query and all things that are required for that, and also apply some automation. So, without further ado, let's grab a cup of coffee and I'll see you in a minute. That was a really nice cup of coffee. So let's now talk about detecting threats, because that's actually where Azure Sentinel analytics rules are made for, to detect threats based on logs that you submit to Azure Sentinel. But how can we detect threats? Well, there are a couple of methods. We have out of the box detections, which will help you to detect threats. And we can customly define our own logic to detect threats. Out of the box, you will get alerts from other Microsoft solutions that you connect. We have Azure Sentinel Fusion, which is a really cool machine learning model that correlates between multiple alerts that are generated in multiple sources. And we have rule templates available, which are basically custom scheduled rules where all the alert logic is already filled in for you. And I will discuss them in a minute. So if you connect a other Microsoft solution, the solution is capable of itself by generating alerts. And normally these alerts reside only within that specific solution. But by connecting Azure Sentinel, we can configure the connector to copy the alerts from the source product into Azure Sentinel. So you have a holistic view of all the alerts and things that are happening in your environment. This is really helpful if you want to correlate between multiple alerts and that kind of stuff. As I mentioned earlier, we also have Azure Sentinel Fusion, which is a machine learning that is currently capable of detecting around 90 multi-stage threats. You need to have a lot of connectors configured for that. We need to have Azure Active Directory Identity Protection. You need to have Microsoft Cloud App Security configured. Microsoft Defender for Endpoint is required, Azure Defender, and you also optionally can configure a Palo Alto solution there. And it is really awesome. If a alert happens in Identity Protection, and later you also we see alerts in Defender for Endpoint, Cloud App Security, etc., it's able to create one incident based of those multiple alerts that are happening. So it's correlating between these alerts and will generate one multi-stage incident for that. You can enable Azure Sentinel Fusion by deploying the advanced multi-stage attack detection. You can only define one of these rules and it will automatically do all the magic behind. It's what I call a black box rule. We can't see the logic that's behind the rule, but it works awesome. Okay, let me quickly show you how you can set up the Azure Sentinel Fusion alert rule. If we go to analytics, you go to templated rules. We can filter here on multi-stage. And here we have the advanced multi-stage attack detection, which is based on Fusion. If you can click on this, you see what connectors need to be configured in order to have this working. And the only thing you have to do in order to bring this rule in place is click on create rule. We can set up some automation if you would like. Click on review and create, and create. There you go. Your Azure Sentinel Fusion rule is now available. If you would like to disable it, you can click on disable over here. If you would like to alter the automated response, that can be done over here, just like a normal scheduled rule. Next, there are also rule templates, and they are a really good point for starting. It's basically the scheduled analytics rule, but with all the logic filled in for you. So the KQL query, the alert logic, all these settings are visible for you. You can change them to your own needs. So it's a really good point to start with. If you're getting a lot of noise, you can change the alert logic and make sure it fits to your needs. Depending on the template rule that you deploy, certain connectors need to be set up. There are detections available which only requires you to set up one connector, but there are also detections available which correlate over multiple sources. And of course, then you need to have all the required sources configured as connectors. Let me give you a brief demo of the template rules which are available. If you go to analytics, hit rule templates over here. Here you have the list of all the rule templates which are currently available. And these are multiple pages. You see there are a lot of rule templates available. What I would recommend you is to filter on data sources. For example, if Azure Activity is one thing that you would like to build use cases or analytic rules for, filter on it. Here we have a rare subscription level operations in Azure. If we can click on create rule, it will bring us to the rule creation wizard, which is actually the same as for the custom scheduled rules, but all the fields are filled in for you right now. You can see they have the query visible over here. You can change it if needed. The entities are over here. The scheduling is already set up, event grouping, etc. So this is really helpful. If you click on create over here, this template rule is now converted into a Azure Sentinel rule. which you can also edit. And still the rule logic is available for you. So what I recommend you is start with a template rule and alter it to your needs. So it doesn't bring you any noise or alert fatigue. Alter this to your environment. So we also have scheduled rules. Basically the custom analytics rules where you can define all logic by yourself. So what does a scheduled analytics rule consist of? Well, first of all, we have the detection logic. Secondly, we have the classification settings. We can set a severity and the MITRE tactics, which will be visible when the detection rule triggers a alert. We have scheduling information available. It's a scheduled rule. So Azure Sentinel is a query-based SIEM. That means that with a certain interval, we run some alert logic, and based on that alert logic, we generate incidents. So, and as part of your analytics rule, you have to define the scheduling information. We also have entity mapping, which is part of the analytics rule. You can imagine you can ingest a lot of data into Azure Sentinel, and depending on the log source that you are using, fields can differ from name. For example, we can have a table where we have an account column, and we can also have a table where we have a username column. It basically means the same, and by using entity mapping, we can map those columns to a type of entity. We also have grouping information available. If a alert triggers a lot of time, we can group all those alerts together in one incident. And lastly, we have automated response, which is based on the logic apps. So the base of an analytics rule is a Kusto query. And these Kusto queries are there to filter down in the event data that's in Azure Sentinel, and also correlate in this data between multiple events that are happening. I get a lot of questions about the Kusto query language, how you can start with it, where can we learn it, etc. And I have one lesson over here. Just start by doing. Just deploy a sandbox Azure Sentinel environment. Configure a connector to connect it with your Azure subscription, so the Azure Activity Log is available over there, which is really easy to do. And then just create some detections. Just design a scenario and create the required Kusto query, which is needed to filter and detect all the events on which your analytic rule will be based. There are a couple of sources, however, which will help you in learning the Kusto query language. There is a really good Pluralsight course available. It's about 4 hours, and after you finish the course, you are a Kusto hero. There's also Microsoft Docs, all things that you can type in a Kusto query, you can define over there with a good explanation and samples also available. You can also go to medium.org and go to my page. I now and then write blogs about Kusto query detections. And lastly, I have a good colleague of mine who is running the website KustoKing.com, where we also discusses a lot of Kusto related stuff. So just go and start by doing, and make use of the sources that I've written down in the slide over here. And I'll also have them as a clickable link in the description of this video. So let's now talk about scheduling, because this is a really important thing. And I see a lot of people making mistakes over here, which can result in events that are not monitored, or a lot of noise. So let me try to explain this as clearly as possible. We can define a interval on which the query logic is getting executed. In the example that you see over here, we run that every 5 hours. And when that query gets executed, we look back to a data set that is generated over the past 5 hours. And as you can see in my example over here, it runs at 10 a.m., 3 p.m., 8 p.m., 1 a.m., 6 a.m. And we continuously look back to a period of 5 hours ago. And that is really good, depending on the detection that you would like to do. A common mistake that I see that's made quite often is that the query interval and the lookback time frame is not corresponding with the correlation between events. So we have a query interval and a loopback time frame which corresponds with each other, but we also try to correlate events. And in this case, we try to correlate between two suspicious events. For example, a user that gains admin permissions and creates an admin account within 12 hours, that are two events, gaining admin permissions and creating an admin account. And it can be really suspicious, right? Getting the rights and directly creating an admin account. And we have a time span of 12 hours. So if you have a query interval of 5 hours and you have a look back time frame of 5 hours, and the time between those events can be, for example, 10 hours, we will never detect this suspicious behavior. So make sure in this case that your look back data frame is set to 12 hours so we can check for the correlation of these two events. So let's now discuss entity mapping. Within Azure Sentinel, we can configure a lot of data sources, and they all use their own tables. And those tables are actually not standardized, so we can have a table with authentication events where the user principal name is set in a username field, and we can have a file access events table where all the account names are set in a UPN table. So what we can do within the entity mapping configuration of our rule is make sure that the username and the UPN always will end up as a account entity on our alert. And we have a lot of these entities available by default: IP addresses, URLs, file hashes, accounts, Azure resources, cloud applications, DNS, hosts, and even your custom entities you can configure in Azure Sentinel. And this is really important because when we want to investigate an alert, you want to map out the whole incident. So what other alerts are happened over there, what accounts were being used, what hosts were being used. And we might see that in some cases, that the same hosts or the same accounts were used. And it's really hard to create that correlation if you have different entity types. So as I mentioned earlier, we can group incidents and we can configure incident creation. By default, for each alert, an incident is created, and we can disable this incident creation. And we also have alert grouping available. It's disabled by default, but I strongly recommend to enable it because it can help you reducing a lot of noise and even alert fatigue. Alert grouping allows us to group alerts based on their analytics rule, or we can group alerts based on selected entities or even all entities that were part of that alert. Let me give you an example of this. For the table below, I have configured alert grouping to be enabled. I have set up a grouping time frame of 1 hour, and all entities that are part of an alert need to match. So if you see in the first two rows, we have an account name over there with an IP address, and these events happened within 1 hour. So Azure Sentinel will group them as two alerts and generate one incident out of them. In the third row, we have an account and an IP address and a time frame. And even though the account name is the same as the two rows that that are listed before, the IP address is different. And as all entities must match, this will result in a new incident because the IP address is different, so not all entities match. On the fourth row, we have actually the same situation. We have an IP address that's being used earlier, but a different account name. And also the time on which the event happened is not within the same hour as the incidents that we saw before. So a new incident is getting created. On the last two rows, we have the same account and the same IP. But the time frame is different. The one occurs at 2:30 p.m. and the other occurs at 8:30 p.m. And the time spent between those two events is bigger than 1 hour. So for those two events, a separate incident will create it. So alert grouping can help you a lot by reducing the amount of incidents that are getting created. And this is especially helpful if we look back in the scenario that I mentioned you earlier, where we have a query period of, for example, 5 hours, and we look back at a data frame of 12 hours. So we potentially have the scenario available over there where we can generate double alerts. And by using the grouping logic in Azure Sentinel, we can group them together so they are becoming one incident. So we also have automated response, and I created a video earlier. I will put a link in the description of this video so you can watch my video about automation rules over there. So let me give you a quick summarization of that video. Within Azure Sentinel, we are now able to set up automation rules. And the automation rule holds the response logic, which can be really simple by just changing severity fields or whatever field you want to change, or the more advanced scenarios where we run a logic app which can do anything in your environment. And we can connect these automation rules to our analytics rule. So let me give you a couple of last tips over here before I'm going to show you how this is all working in Azure Sentinel. It all starts with a plan. You need to think of a scenario that you would like to cover upfront. And it's really important to know where you can find data. So you need to know what connectors need to be connected, what data is getting through these connectors, and even what events are getting logged by the connectors. Really important to know. So, and also I would like to encourage you to not just go to Azure Sentinel and create a bunch of alerts based on what you think is okay, because you probably will end up in a lot of alerts happening, which could result in alert fatigue, which is the situation where you have more alerts than you can handle. So normally there are a couple of drivers on which you can decide to create a analytic rule. So one of the drivers can be incident driven. An incident happened last week. You investigated that incident and you saw that a couple of events were crucial for that incident to happen. And you create an alert logic around these events. When they are happening again, you will get an incident in Azure Sentinel. So we also have situation related drivers. For example, you have crown jewels. You want to protect them well. As they are your crown jewels, you know what normal behavior is. And I would recommend over there to create alert logic based on abnormal behavior that could happen over there. Lastly, you have intelligence related drivers. for example, a new exploit is available, or you saw something in the news that a lot of attacks are happening. These are also things that you can investigate, where most likely a lot of indicators of compromise are already shared through the internet, and you can create alert logic based on the indicators of compromise that are shared. So with that, it's time for a demo, and I think of a scenario that I would like to demo. An incident happened at Demo Company. The attacker opened port 3389, which is the port for RDP, on an Azure VM, so he slash she was able to use RDP. Changing network security groups is only allowed by a network administrator in a maintenance window. The maintenance window of a Demo Company is between 7 p.m. and 8 p.m. daily. We have a network administrator and his account is stated over here. And we automatically want to disable the user account of the user which is executing the change on the network security group when the rule is triggered. So we now need to think of a plan, decide what log sources are required. I think in this case it's okay if we only use the Azure Activity Log. So we need to create the rule logic. So we want to filter out the events which are illegal. So we need to create a rule logic for events that changes network security groups and changes that are not being done by the network admin or by the network admin and outside of the maintenance window. And lastly, we have to create a logic app which will automatically disable our user once a network security group is created. Okay, so let me now show you my workflow of creating a new analytics rule. Before I started recording this video, I did two things. One, I made sure that the events are already in my log analytics workspace. So I did go to a random VM in my MSDN subscription, change the network security group. So the events are in there now. Secondly, I made sure that my connectors are configured well. So for all my Azure subscriptions, the Azure Activity Log is getting forwarded to Azure Sentinel. So what I normally do is going to explore the data. So if I go to Azure Activity and limit this to 100, you see all events that are currently in my log analytics workspace that have been generated the last 24 hours. It's actually a lot, but on the end over here, we have a column and that's called created or updated security rule. And this is the operation that is part of changing a network security group. So if I go to the beginning and check this time, the times are in UTC. So depending on your time zone, you have to add or subtract a couple of hours. But this corresponds with the moment when I changed my network security group. Also, if you preparing your data set like I did, be aware of the ingestion time that is coming with Azure Sentinel. I had to wait for I think 5 or 6 minutes in order to have my event pop up in Azure Sentinel. So be aware of that. So I already have prepared a couple of queries that we are going to discuss in a moment. Let's first go back to the scenario, because we are having a lot of constraints over here. So we would like to create a analytics rule that triggers an alert when something is happening on network security group outside of the maintenance window. And if we are in the maintenance window, only network admin at my domain is allowed to change network security groups. So I found out that it is quite hard to have both these constraints in one analytics rule. So I figured out it's best to create two analytics rules in order to tackle this scenario. So let me show you our first scenario. That is the scenario where a network security group gets deployed outside of the maintenance window. Whether it is a network security admin or another user, in none of the cases this is a legal event to happen. So let's create an alert when these events are happening. So we have the Azure Activity Log, which is the table where the events are logged. We filter down on the events that are happened during the last 8 hours. We filter out the events that are happened during the maintenance window. So between 7 p.m. and 8 p.m. Next, we are going to filter on the operation name. In this case, we filter on the create or update security rule operation name. This is the operation of changing a network security group. And lastly, I only want to filter on events that are executed successfully. So the activity status need to be succeeded. So if I click on this, it will narrow the whole thing down to one event that happened. And that was me generating a network security group this morning. So this is the first scenario. Let me now show you the second scenario where I would like to rule out deployment of another user other than the network security admin during maintenance window. So what I did, I first created a list of network administrators. In this case, it's only one administrator, but in the future, we don't know what is going to happen. It might be that multiple users are responsible for our network, so this list can grow. I would like to have this list outside of my query so that I don't have to adjust the query logic when I add a new network administrator. What I do next is getting all the events out of the Azure Activity Table, filter them down to the last 8 hours, so I only have the events that are happened during the last 8 hours. Then I filter on the events that are only happened during the maintenance window, so 7 p.m. till 8 p.m. And the status of the activity needs to be succeeded. And the color should not be in network administrators. So if with a strange account other than network admin, I now create or update a network security group inside of the maintenance window, this alert rule will trigger. So in this case, there are no results available as I did not do any deployment in the maintenance time window. So that are my queries. Let's now go and set up these analytics rules. So if I go to analytics, I click on create and create a new scheduled query rule. And let's give it a name. Illegal network security group deployment, and this is the outside maintenance window. That's the name. So for description, I will leave that empty right now, but I encourage you to give a good description over here. The tactic, I think it's persistent, because we can open a port so we can get in later if we are an attacker, and the severity, medium is okay for me. The status can be set to enabled. So let's drop in the KQL query over here. And now we have to configure our entities. There are a couple of entities which I think are interesting. That is the IP address. And the address, and that's called the color IP address in the Azure Sentinel table, in the Azure Activity Table. Another thing that is the account which I saw, This is also required when we are going to do a response on it. So for the account, we also have the name, and that is the color in this case. So as you see, account corresponds with the column color over here. Next, we have the scheduling. In this case, it's okay to run the query every 8 hours. A look back for a data set of 8 hours. As you saw in my query, I started with where time generated is smaller than 8 hours. And that basically means that we pick all the events that are happening at 8 hours from triggering this analytics rule. So if we have more than one, if we have more than zero results, this analytics rule will trigger an alert. So here we have the incident settings. I would like to create an incident when this alert is triggered. So we leave this on enabled. And I also would like to enable alert grouping. For me, it's very helpful to have just one single incident per attacker instead of just a bunch of incidents for each network security group that he or she changed. So I will enable alert grouping when all entities match between my alerts. So next up is our automated response. I will leave this empty right now. We first have to define and create our logic app that is responsible for the automated response before we can configure it over here. So I'll leave that empty. Next up, we have the review, and I will create my rule right now. So as you can see, it's created over here. So in the meantime, I have created my second analytics rule, the rule that is responsible for checking the events inside of the maintenance window. If I click on this, you'll see the query over here. This corresponds with the query that I showed you earlier. And the settings are the same as for the outside maintenance window analytics rule. So we have the analytics rules defined now, but we still have to do something with our automated response. So if I go over to my home page over here, I have created a logic app. This logic app holds the logic to execute the response when these types of incidents are happening. So let me make this a little bit bigger for you. So what I did first is to set up the trigger. This logic app will trigger when an incident is created in Azure Sentinel. Secondly, I collected all the account entities from this incident. For each of these entities, for each of these accounts, sorry, I collected the user. I collected the user first because I had to set up a couple of variables over here in order to update the user. What I did is add the setting for account enabled, and I will set it to no when this response is getting executed. So I think this is basically the response that was stated in the scenario earlier. We want to disable the account when an illegal network security group change is made. And that's what this logic app is doing for us. So let me now to go back to Azure Sentinel. And we are now going to set up an automation rule that will hold this logic and is bound to our analytics rule. So I will call this disable account so I can reuse this automation rule for other incidents. I will select my illegal network security group deployment analytics rules. And the actions that I want to do is run a playbook. And the playbook that I would like to use is the auto respond. It's currently not selectable. And there is stated no Azure Sentinel permissions. What I can do over here is manage playbook permissions and navigate to my resource group where the logic app is stated. It's the demo Sentinel Resource Group. Click on Apply. Just wait for a moment. And now we are able to select this one. We will not have a expiration date set up on this rule, and it is ordered as the fourth rule to apply. And for me, that's okay. So hit apply. We have the disable account automation rule over here. And if I now go to my analytics and we open these rules and go to the automated response panel over here, you see that when an incident is created, it will now automatically run the disable accounts playbook. And that's done because we have set up our automation rule to work with this analytics rule. So as you can see, I'm currently logged in with my demo account, so it's safe to have that one disabled. If I go to my demo logstash machine, go to networking, I can change a network security group. And it's currently outside of the maintenance window, and this user is not allowed to change any network security group. So if everything went well, this user will get disabled. So if I click on add a inbound security rule, let's change this one to port 8081. So now port 8081 is also open for this virtual machine. As soon as this event gets into Azure Sentinel and my alert rule is triggered, this will disable this user. So and here we are back again. It's a couple of hours later. I had to wait in order to have the data ingested in Azure Sentinel and wait for the moment that my alert rule got triggered. But here we are. Let's have a look. Here we have the entities, the demo user which I used, the alert on which the incident is based. And what we can do is go over here to my Logic app. And you'll see that it succeeded to run. In order to make this working, I had to make a small change. We first used the Azure AD connector over here, but I didn't got that working. So I changed it for the Graph API. This is where we directly work with the Graph API and disable the account manually in an HTTP request instead of using the activity that's provided there by Microsoft. So if we now go over to the user, I have the demo user over here, and you can see that block sign in is now set to yes. So the user cannot log in anymore. So he will not be able to make any mess of our network security groups anymore. So in this Azure vlog, you learned about analytics rules. We first had a look into the out-of-the-box solutions that are available in Azure Sentinel. Mainly the Azure Sentinel Fusion Analytics Rule. This is an analytics rule which is powered by machine learning and helps you correlating events that are happening in multiple alert sources. The alert logic that is behind this rule is machine learning and it's not visible for you. And we also had a look at template rules. Whereas in the Azure Sentinel Fusion rule, the logic is hidden away from you, you can see the logic that is available for a rule template. You can see the KQL query which is being used. You can see all the classification settings, etc. You can even change them to fit to your own environment. Next, we had a look at custom scheduled rules. These are rules where you can define everything yourself. We created our own rules. You saw how this rule was triggered and how the Logic app automatically disabled an account. I think this is really important. When you see attacks are happening more often and they are getting more complex, it requires us to automate a lot of incident response. Automation rules in combination with our analytic rules help us a lot with that.
So with that, I would like to end this Azure vlog. I hope you like this content. I hope you learned something. If so, please hit the thumbs up button. If you still have questions, please use the comments function of YouTube. I will answer them as soon as possible. Also, subscribe to this channel. And of course, I'll see you in the next one. Bye.